Hello friends and welcome to a new video. So far we have seen many examples for a countable set. So do we have a promising candidate for an uncountable set? Yes, there is. Set of real numbers is an uncountable set. We use proof by contradiction method to prove that set of real numbers is an uncountable set. So we suppose that the set of real numbers is not uncountable, but the set of real numbers is countable. Look at the lemma which states that any subset of a countable set is also countable. So we are not going to prove this lemma in this video. We prove this lemma in the next video. Here we will just assume this lemma for our required proof. Alright, so it states that any subset of a countable set is also countable. We suppose that the set of real numbers is countable set. Now you take any subset of the set of real number, that set is going to be a countable set. So the set of real numbers between 0 and 1 is going to be countable set. Okay. So meaning that we can list the elements or that real numbers between 0 and 1 in a sequence. Now since the set of real numbers between 0 and 1 is countable, we can list the real numbers between 0 and 1 in a sequence in some order R1, R2, R3 and so on. Let the decimal representation of the real numbers be this way. R1 equal to 0.D11, D12, D13, D14 and so on. R2 is 0.D21, D22, D23 and so on. R3 is 0.D31, D32 and so on. And R4 is 0.D41, D42 and so on. And similarly, the list goes this way. Okay. Where each Dij belongs to set 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, so for example, if R1 equal to 0.234571 2, then here D11 is 2, D12 is 3, D13 is 4, D14 is 5 and so on. So as we have mentioned, because the set of real numbers between 0 and 1 is countable, we can list all the elements, right? So there is a listing R1, R2, R3 and so on. There is a listing. Now the idea is to form a new real number R which is not in the list. Let's see. So we are trying to form a new real number R which is between 0 and 1 but has not been listed. Okay, let's see how. So this real number R is of the form 0.D1, D2, D3, D4 and so on. The aim is to form such a real number R where D1 is not same as D11, D2 is not same as D22, D3 is not same as D33, D4 is not same as D44 and so on. So if you see, they are the diagonal elements in the decimal representation of the real numbers that we have listed. Let the rule for determining the decimal digits of the new real number be this way. Di equal to 4 when Dii is not equal to 4 and Di equal to 5 when Dii equal to 4. For example, consider the listing of the real numbers this way. R1 equal to 0.237941102 and so on. R2 equal to 0.445019138 and so on. R3 equal to 0.091874 and so on. And R4 equal to 0.8055301 and so on. And in this way, we list the real numbers. Okay. So now we need to form a new real number R, right? So R equal to 0.4544 and so on here. How? So in our new real number formed, D1 equal to 4 because D11 was not equal to 4. D2 equal to 5 because D22 was equal to 4. D3 equal to 4 because D33 was not equal to 4. D4 is 4 because D44 was not equal to 4. And in this way, we get a new real number. Okay. Here, we take a unique decimal expansion for every real number. In general, every non-zero terminating decimal has two equal representations. For example, 0.39 is same as 0.38 infinite nines and 0.9 infinite is same as 1. We have already seen that 99.9 bar is 100. So, in that manner, we can say that every non-zero terminating decimal has two equal representations. So here we exclude the expansion having a tail end of n digits entirely 9. For example, 0.38 is included but 0.37 infinite 9s is excluded. Now we have formed a new real number, right? Now we need to claim that our new real number is not same as any of the real numbers that we have listed so far. So the new real number r equal to 0.d1, d2, d3, d4 and so on, where di equal to 4 when dii is not equal to 4 and di equal to 5 when dii equal to 4. So this real number is not same as any of the r1, r2 and r3 and so on, the real numbers we have listed. How? The decimal expansion of the r differs from the decimal expansion of ri in the ith place to the right of the decimal point for each I. We can prove that our new real number r is not equal to any of the number that we have listed. Let's see. So r is different from r1 because d1 is not same as d11. Okay. And r is different from r2 because d2 is different from d22. And r is different from r3 because d3 is different from d33. And in this way, we can see that r is different from all of the real numbers that we have listed. Now, we see that there is a real number r between 0 and 1 that is not in the list. So, the assumption that all real numbers between 0 and 1 can be listed was wrong. Okay. So, it means that the set of real numbers between 0 and 1 is not countable. It is uncountable. So, we have proved that set of real numbers between 0 and 1 is uncountable. Now take a look at the lemma which states that any set with an uncountable subset is an uncountable set. We will do the proof of this lemma in the next video. Okay. So here we assume the lemma. Any set with an uncountable subset is an uncountable set. So we have proved that the set of real numbers between 0 and 1 is uncountable.
And by making use of this lemma, we prove that set of real numbers is uncountable.